Om Namah Shivaya. Today we are going to see file handling in Python, chapter 5. Okay. So what are the modules under this lesson? Why need file handling? Why we need file handling? Why we have to use that files? Then different types of files in Python. Okay, using Python, what are the different types of files we are going to create and control? Okay, then Python file handling system, about how to create, how to modify that file, everything comes under that, and practical approach for that, the coding, what are the different methods for doing that will be seen. See here, what is the need for file handling? Okay, so we may have so many data while executing a program. So in a Python program, the program itself contains so many data, like x equal to 1 plus something like that. We will give so many names and its values. Now program itself has so many data. Then while running, we will give inputs. Okay, input data we will give, and the program will give some output data also. All these data can be stored permanently. For that purpose, we are using files. Why we have to store file? Because we need to retrieve it later, the same data we want, so we can retrieve it later. Then second one, the data can be stored permanently. Okay, so in a file, it will be stored in an organized manner, so it is easy for retrieving and accessing it. Okay, for searching it, everything, it will be easier. When it is stored in a file, it will be stored in an organized manner, and it will be stored in permanently, and it is easy to retrieve it, access it, and for searching any data, it is easy. And then we can modify the data because it is permanently stored. Later we can open it, see it, refer it, and we can even modify the data stored in that. Understand? For that purpose, we are using file handling system in Python. See, in other applications you could have seen, in Word, Excel, we have created so many files and we will editing it, and we will, for many purpose, we will create many files. In the same way, we can create files here. Usually files will be created for data storage. Okay, for example, if you are creating a school maintenance system, then for that we have to create so many classes and details of students, details of teachers, details of class. Everything will be retrieved and stored permanently. We want to store all those data permanently, and later on we can retrieve the data and we can make some processes on that. So for example, if some teacher is coming and asking for list of class 1 students I want, then we can give using some programming methods, we can retrieve all the data of that particular class and give, because it is permanently stored. So that is called files. So literally, what is file? Okay, what is a file? File is a sequence of bytes on the disk or any permanent storage. Okay, it is sequence of bytes, nothing but sequence of bytes represents some data. It may be of different forms, it may be text, or it may be voice message, that means audio message, video message, or any binary message it may be. So different types of data can be stored as bytes on the disk, okay, or any other permanent storage. That is called file. File is a sequence of bytes, and it is a file. One single file, if you take all the data in that file, will be related. For example, if the files containing students' data, then it will be related only. All the students' data will be stored there. That means students' data will be like name of the student, address, class, section, all the things, it will be related only. Related means in the sense class 1 detail or class 1A detail. So all those are belongs to same class. So somehow it will be related. So that is how the file is created. And the files of Python are of two types. Okay, one, it may be a binary file or it may be a text file. Understand? It may be a binary file or it may be a text file. Two types of Python files are there. What is binary and what is text file? See, binary files are nothing but the data is stored in the form of binary, right? And text files are nothing but the data is stored in the form of ASCII code or Unicode. Binary means the raw data, actually the bits we know, no? In terms of bits, it stores the data. So there is no need of conversion while reading the data, because that is not used, not going to be used by the user directly. That is going to be used by some other program or application. So that is called binary file. And the text file is the user created file for better understanding of his understanding of him. It will be stored in ASCII and Unicode, and that will be converted, translated into normal readable form whenever he reads it or he writes it. Okay, so when he inputs it in his own normal English, it will be retrieved from the user to the computer, and the computer will convert it into ASCII and Unicode for storing it. Okay, whenever he reads it, it will be converted into high level language. That means normal English it will be converted, so that user can easily read. So this is how text files and the binary files differ. So what is the main difference? Text files need some translation. Okay, needs some translation, but binary files doesn't. No translation is required. And both are data files. Both stores them. Both of the files stores some data only, and that will be permanent, and it will be pertaining to specific application for later use. Okay, so it will be used for some particular application. Like we have so many files, like text files are there, score sheet, spreadsheet files are there, document files are there, .doc files are there. Using the extension of the file, you can see what kind of application it is opt for. Okay, so extension, file extension .txt, .doc or .xl file for .xlm, like that it goes. Next, what are the different file handling operations? So Python has but not only Python, any file, when you create any file, it has some important four operations, like five actually. See, a file can be created as new, so that is creating, and a file can be read if it is already existing, the file can be opened for reading, and the file content can be updated and deleted also. Okay, all these files are called as CRUD operations: creation, reading, updating and deletion. So this is generally called as CRUD operation, that that files involve these operations. Usually Python files, we first open it. Opening the file may be for many purpose, maybe for reading, writing or appending. Okay, so opening the file for reading or writing or appending. Appending means adding more data into the existing data, then closing the file. So every file which is opened must be closed at the end. That is the rule. Next, so this is how the file is being handled. Then how it goes actually. So first, the creation of file. So using open only, we will either create a new file or we will open an existing file. Okay, depends on the option passed inside. A file can be opened as a new one, or it can be existing file can be opened and it can be created as a new one. New file can also be created. So that is the first step, creating file using open. Then opening with the mode. What mode you are giving? What is the purpose of opening the file? Maybe you want to read the content of the file, or you may want to write something into that file. Okay, maybe for reading or writing. So that is the method of that means the option you are giving in open. Then work. What work you are going to do with that file? You may be reading, or you may write on that, or you may append some more data with that existing data. So that is called A mode. Okay, read, write mode, or A mode means appending. Okay, so after the work is being done, that means you read the data or the file has been written, that means W mode is for a new file. When you are creating, it will be opened in W mode, so that file will be empty and the data will be written on that file. And if you are opening an existing file in W mode, it will be overwritten. Already data will be stored, no? That will be erased and the new data will be stored. And if you are opening it the existing file in append mode, the data, previous data will be preserved and the new data will be added with that. So that is called appending mode. So for any cause you are opening, okay, maybe for reading or writing or appending, so your work will be done using this, and then after finishing your work the file must be closed. So these are the usual general operations with file. So you'll be creating the file first, then you'll be opening that file for reading or writing or for some other work, or after finishing your work you have to close that file. These are the sequence of operations you are doing in a file. Now let's see how will you do that, okay, how the Python system actually does it. Okay, here while opening a file you have to open it with the file name and the mode. Okay, the mode of opening must be mentioned here. So if you are opening it for with the X here, the file name will be passed here. The file name is actually the file name with that full path, its full path must be passed here. Then mode will be X if it is created, actually if the file is created as a new one it will be X here. In the mode you have to give X, and if it is existing file you have to open it with the R mode, that means you can read it, okay, R mode or W mode also, because you are going to write something and that means W mode. We have a set of modes, a table of modes. We will see what are the different kind of modes available, and some additional modes are there. This is for text file and binary file. So if you are opening it in the T mode it will be like text mode, and B mode is for binary. We will see how it works. See, this is the code for opening a file. So whenever you are opening, you should assign it to a file pointer or file handler. Okay, here file, file, file is the file handler. So here the file demo.txt is opened for read. Okay, so this file must already exist, then only we can open it for read. So usually if you are not passing any mode here, then by default it will be reading only, understand? So without any mode, if you pass any file here, the system, file handling system, Python system will check whether the file is existing or not. So if it is not, it will throw some error. Okay, so always be careful while giving this mode when you open a file. See here, without R mode also it will be taken as the file is opened for reading, right? So this is for reading the file and this is for printing the contents of the file. See, a file dot read will read the content of the file and then prints it in the console. In our console we'll see how this works. See here, I have given file equal to open of C Senthil demo1.txt. I'll give you demo.txt. So this file is actually existing in my folder, C folder, then Senthil. There is a file called demo and I have given some sentence, some data inside it. Now you can see this one, okay. So file dot read will read the content and the prints. So see how this works. So this will be read and it should be printed. We'll check file open Senthil X. Okay, see here I have created X. I have given, so X is means it creates the file for new. Okay, so X means it creates a file for new. So I am creating a new file. See, 2 I'll give demo 2. So now a new file will be created. Okay, for reading I have to give a R. Here I have given X, so it will read, it will create a new file. Okay, if the file is existing it will throw error because it cannot create the file with the same name, so it will become duplicate, no? So it shows error if the file name is existing when you give X mode. So X mode when you give, you should be careful that the file is not already existing. So now we are creating a file, right? So now demo 2 must be created. So I have not given this line, I commented because for now we are just creating a file, there is no content, so we can't read it. Now I'll run this. See here, so the file is created. Now I'll go and check whether the file is created. See here, there is an empty file created now. Understand? Now I want to read this file, already existing demo.txt. I want to read. So for that I have to change this mode into or, and then here demo.txt. The full path must be passed. Okay, demo.txt I have given. So now I am going to read that and print it in our console. So now the content of the demo.txt will be printed here. You can see here, see, Om Namah Shivaya is printed here. So that's what the file contains. Understand? See, demo.txt contains Om Namah Shivaya. That's it. So now our file has executed successfully. So these are the lines for opening a file, read mode or X mode, and reading it and printing it. Simple file opening lines, just one line. Okay, open simply will do, because these file systems are inbuilt and we can directly use it without any object, and this is called a file handler. File is called file handler. We will see remaining in the next video.